Hello and welcome to a Vector Tuts Quick Tip Screencast. My name is Cheryl Graham. This is going to be a quick and fun one. We're going to wrap a ribbon around a cone that'll make it look like a Christmas tree. First, take the line segment tool and draw out a line at an angle like this. It can be any color, the color doesn't matter. Now go to the effects menu to 3D Revolve. Click the preview button and you should see a cone like this. See this little gap here? We don't want that, so choose front as the position in this drop-down menu. All these values should be 0, and the angle should be 360, going from the left edge. If it goes from the right, it'll look like an inverted cone, so make sure you have it on the left. You can adjust the lighting in this section at the bottom, and if you don't see the section, choose More Options. You can move the light source around in this window here, and you can see how that's reflected on the 3D object. To make the ribbon that will wrap around the cone, take the rectangle tool and click once on the artboard. You could just draw it freehand, but we want a nice even number for the height. I want it to be green, so I'll change the stroke color I have, then swap the fill and stroke colors using the keyboard shortcut Shift X. Next, make sure you have the selection tool chosen, then press the return or enter key to bring up the move dialog box. Enter 0 in the horizontal field, then in the vertical field, enter twice the height of the rectangle. We want to make a copy that is evenly spaced from the original, so press Copy. Then press Command D several times to repeat the action to make a few more copies, all evenly spaced. To get the final illusion of these stripes as one continuous ribbon wrapping around the cone, take the Shear tool and drag the stripes so that the new position of each side is centered in the space between the original rectangles. Now drag the stripes into the Symbols panel. In the Options dialog that appears, you can give your symbol a name, but you don't have to pay attention to anything else in this box. Now you'll see the newly created symbol, and the group of stripes can just be deleted. Now select the cone and click on the 3D effect in the Appearance panel. In the dialog box, click Map Art. In this dialog, you'll see that the 3D object has two surfaces, which are highlighted in red, on the object itself. This cone has an inside surface and an outside surface, and it's hard to tell which is which, so you might have to do some trial and error. I know that surface 2 is what I want, so I'll choose it, then find my symbol in this menu here, and select it. You can now see the stripes on part of the cone, and if you click Scale to Fit, it will do just that. Of course, we don't want to see the cone itself, so click Invisible Geometry. Then, to give it some dimension, choose Shade Artwork. Now you can go back to the lighting options and adjust those if you like. Increase the blend steps for a smoother surface, and decrease the amount of ambient light for more contrast. And that's all there is to it. You can now add some 3D spheres or other decorations to complete your tree.